If someone unsuccessfully attempts to unlock an iPhone or iPad too many times, then an iPhone is disabled message will inevitably pop up. Luckily, there are multiple solutions to this problem, and in this video, we're going to cover them. But first of all, you may be wondering why your iPhone is disabled. Well, iPhones are disabled for security reasons, otherwise a hacker could try every possible combination until they got into your phone. But just because your iPhone is disabled doesn't mean someone tried to unlock your device without permission. An iPhone or iPad may become disabled if a child plays around and gets locked out, or maybe you simply forgot your passcode. Unfortunately, there is no way to unlock a disabled iPhone or iPad, which means you'll be using Finder, iTunes, iCloud, or Recovery Mode to erase your device. Once you've erased your device and gotten it out of disabled mode, you can focus on restoring your device. Here are some guidelines on what method might work best for you. If your Mac isn't updated to macOS Catalina or you have a PC, you'll be using the iTunes method. If you're using a Mac updated to macOS Catalina, you'll be using the Finder method. If you're signed into iCloud and have Find My iPhone enabled, you'll be using the iCloud method. And if you don't use iCloud and can't use the Finder or iTunes method, the Recovery Mode method is the option for you. So let's dive right in. The first fix is with iTunes. If you have a locked or disabled iPhone or iPad and have a PC or haven't updated your Mac to Catalina, then this is the solution that you need to try. First, plug your iPhone into your computer using your USB cord. If it doesn't automatically open, launch iTunes manually. In iTunes, click on the icon of your device located near the top and toward the left side of your screen. This will open all the information about your device and what's on it. Tap Summary, and here you will see the option to restore iPhone. Click on that. If you get an error message that Find My iPhone must be turned off, then you should use the iCloud method or Recovery Mode method instead. Once your iPhone has been restored, it will start up like any new iPhone would. Follow the setup process, and when it's time to restore from a backup, use either the most recent iTunes or iCloud backup available. If for whatever reason this doesn't work for you and you don't meet the iCloud method requirements, skip to using Recovery Mode. Now, if you have a Mac that's been updated to Catalina, you will be using Finder to unlock your device. To fix your disabled iPhone or iPad using Finder, connect your device to your computer with a USB cable, and then choose your device from the Finder menu. Then choose Restore Backup. Choose your backup, and if your backups are encrypted, you'll need to enter a passcode. Keep your device connected to your computer until it restarts and syncs. Now let's go over how to fix your disabled iPhone or iPad with iCloud. If you're using this method, then on your computer, open a browser and visit iCloud.com/find. Log in with your Apple ID and password. Select All Devices at the top. Click on the device of yours that is currently disabled. Then click Erase iPhone and then Confirm. Once your device has been wiped, it will power up as any new iPhone would. Go through the setup process. When it's time to restore from a backup, use your most recent backup via iTunes or iCloud. Now, if your computer doesn't recognize your iPhone or iPad or says it's in recovery mode, then you can use recovery mode to set up your device from scratch. To use recovery mode to fix your disabled iPhone or iPad, plug your iPhone into your computer with your USB cable. If it doesn't launch automatically, open iTunes manually. If you've updated your Mac to Catalina, remember to open Finder. From here, you'll need to force restart your iPhone. How you do this will vary depending on your iPhone model. So refer to the article below to figure out which method you need to use to force restart your phone. Once your iPhone or iPad enters recovery mode, find your device in iTunes or the Finder and click on it. A box will appear asking if you want to restore or update your device. Select Restore. It may take some time for your iPhone to download its restored iOS or iPadOS software. If your download takes more than 15 minutes and exits the recovery mode screen, let the download complete, then try over with the forced restart and enter recovery mode again. Once your device has been restored, it will start up like any new iPhone or iPad would. Follow the setup process. When it's time to restore a backup, select the most recent backup you have, either from Finder, iTunes, or via iCloud. And that's all there is to it. Now you know a few different ways that you can fix your disabled iPhone.
If you enjoyed this video tip and would like to see more, go to iPhoneLife.com/insider.